Hey guys!
Oh boy, I usually only get this excited when they say the title of a movie in the movie.
Okay, so this is a three-part series that I wanted to do. Struggles being me.
He said it.
So this is my first series ever. I don't know how this is gonna pan out or how it's gonna go, but what this is I'm going to be talking about 10 struggles per video. So there's three parts. So there's gonna be 30 struggles.
Sorry.
That I experience as being a morbid, obese person. So these might not happen to other people. That's why I am calling this struggles being me.
There it is.
Because saying it as, you know, struggles being obese or, you know, everyone is different and everyone struggles differently. And I think that's why I wanted to make this, is because I wanted people to see what I experience.
Oh, that's why they call it that.
Okay, so number one is back pain. That's kind of like an obvious one. I suffer from really bad lower back pain. I have a bulged / slipped disc. I also experience hip bursitis. I am bad at pronouncing that word. My stomach is really big, and I also have a really, really big butt.
That ass, though.
When I am standing, even for just like 2 minutes, I am in excruciating pain. That's my alarm. I'm gonna stop that.
Excruciating.
I dare you. I double dare you, motherfucker. Say
excruciating.
One more goddamn time.
Just horrid pain. Sometimes I can't even take a full breath. And I know it's because of my weight, because it's gotten worse as I've gained weight.
No shit.
So number two is also a pretty obvious one. I am less energetic. As I gain more weight, I feel more lethargic and just kind of fatigued. Just like... Number three is I can't ride rides at amusement parks. My weight literally stops me from doing things like riding roller coasters. I can't even walk in the amusement park to get to said rides, but that's a whole other struggle that I deal with, but we're not on that one right now. Number four is lack of cute clothing. I will say I try my hardest to find cute clothing, but I feel like I can't do the I hear this a lot from people that are bigger. They can't express themselves with their own raw, true style like they would if they were smaller. And I completely experience the same thing. I feel like I don't really know who I am. Am I girly? Am I more darker? Am I chic? Am I hipster? Am I like an old woman? Like, I don't know my style, because if I find something that fits for me, I take it and I run, girl, because it's hard. And sometimes I'll like find something that fits me and I'm like, I want one in every size.
That doesn't make sense.
Number 5 is needing an expensive scale. I'm currently using a scale that they use at like car shops to measure car parts. Like, get in the zone, AutoZone. So number 6 is housework is hard. The number one most painful thing I could do is wash dishes. Cleaning out the litter box hurts my back.
Help me. Help me.
Number 7 is I'm too big for gym equipment. I went to the gym a couple months ago and I was like, yes, let's do this. I'm so freaking excited because I remembered how I used to feel at the gym. I used to feel so good. I love the elliptical. The elliptical is my jam. So first thing I do is I got on the treadmill and I turned it on and I was trying to walk and it wouldn't move. I was too heavy. The little, you know, the thing that moves, the belt or whatever, it wouldn't move. I was too heavy. And I was like, are you serious? This is so embarrassing. Like, I was so embarrassed. So that's one of the reasons why I'm currently not going to the gym, because it's embarrassing. Number 8 is I can't ride a bike. I can't go camping and things like that. There is a bike that I want if I ever get to the weight that I need to be at. And it just sucks because it's like little things like that I feel like people take for granted. And it's like, I can't even do simple things like that. And it just sucks. And I feel like I'm kind of like living in a cage and like I can't do anything. And people always wonder, why does Amberlynn go out to eat all the time? Why is that the only thing she does? And why does she go to the movies? It's because that's all I can do right now. Number 9 is that towels can't fit around me.
Duh.
Obviously, normal size like shower towels, they can't fit on me. They probably fit like half of my body. So I tried getting larger towels before, and even those don't fit around me. That's just a struggle I have to deal with.
Duh.
So the last one for part one of the series is bras.
Oh, hell no.
And underwear.
Oh, hell no.
Are super uncomfortable for me. Bras.
People call him the fat guy strangler. He's always had a thing for strangling fat guys.
Bitch! You scared me! I'm being serious in this video!
What?
I said I'm being serious in this video and you scared me!
Oh my god!
Eric just scared the crap out of me. I can't seem to find like underwear and bras that are comfortable. I've been wearing the same bras. I do have more than one.
Sure, Jan.
It's like a freaking crazy conspiracy. But as you guys know, hi. I've been wearing the same bras for years now because I can't find any that are as comfortable as these, because this is just what I'm used to. And underwear, they're either riding up,
what,
or they're like cutting me in areas they shouldn't be.
Oh my god,
I can't find comfortable undergarments like at all, and it just sucks really bad. But that's another struggle of being me. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is like just me being raw and like, wow. Some of these things that I have shared or I'm going to be sharing is just hard for me to share. It's reality for me. So I will see you guys in part two. Bye.
Hey, hey, hey! Clap one more time, you're not coming to my birthday. Who did that?
Giggity.